In the first instance, we're acutely aware, to our great regret, that one of the reasons for foreign investors not flowing into South Africa to the extent we would like is the high costs of communication. And we are saying that with our broadband policy, strategy and plan, we are on the cusp of reducing the cost to communicate. Already, the independent regulator has taken a decision to significantly reduce the mobile termination rates and to create a degree of asymmetry to provide for more competition so that the cost to communicate can come down. This will benefit not only the poor and the disadvantaged, or even just the average citizen or user of cell phones in South Africa, but more fundamentally, it will reduce the cost of business for South Africa, and it will benefit the economy as a whole. Of course, we are aware that the mobile operators, some of them at least, who feel they are being disadvantaged, are saying that if this goes ahead as it's intended to be on the 1st of April 2014, they will have less money to invest in new infrastructure. They will have less room to actually help in the delivery of devices to their customers at a lower cost. We understand their concerns. We're trying to find a balance between the needs and interests of the consumers and the economy as a whole on the one hand, and obviously the needs and interests of the mobile operators, who obviously must have a rate of return on their investment that's profitable enough. Now, we've heard this before when we reduce the cost to communicate. In fact, the experience of that over the last 3 years is that they did not suffer particularly, that in fact they increased their revenues and profits and the number of consumers they now have. We think that yes, in the immediate term, they might lose out on profits, but in the medium and short term, with the growth of the economy, with development and job creation, they will have more consumers available to use more of their services. And at the moment, our country has something like 30% of our people using smartphones, which allow for much more use of data. And it's in data in particular that these mobile operators can draw more profits today. So in short, we are saying to both the domestic investors and the foreign investors, we are now significantly reducing the cost to communicate. But the other difficulties which foreign investors tell us are in the way of more effective foreign investment are our transport costs and our energy costs. So government has decided to focus in the period ahead on ICT, transport and energy. And there are links between these three sectors. And we are saying that we are poised now to create the conditions for far more foreign investment and even far more domestic investment. And we are saying to investors, foreign and domestic, please engage with our ministry, engage with our government, and assist us in your own interests as well. We've said it to the mobile operators. Yes, you might lose out a bit on your immediate profits, but the economy as a whole will benefit, and it will create the space for you to get far more of your consumers using far more of your services. So you might sacrifice in the immediate instance some profits, but you will benefit in the medium and short-term interest. Let me also say that our government is very committed to dialogue. We are very keen to engage with both foreign and domestic private sector industry players, not just in the ICT sector, but in any sector. And we think that we're a crucial country for growth on the continent as a whole. Yes, yes, other countries are doing very well. Yes, yes, we hear that foreign investors are saying they might actually get better deals elsewhere in Africa. We do not want to be seen as grudging about that. If other countries in Africa are growing, it is good for us. It's our continent. It's good for the poor and the disadvantaged. Anywhere in the world, if the poor and the disadvantaged benefit, it's good for all of us, including those of us in South Africa. But at the moment, we are the most powerful economy in the world. We have the most advanced infrastructure. We accept that we could have made better decisions. We could have shaped better policies. We could have shaped better legislation. We could have been more abreast of changes in ICT and adjusted our policy and legislation in that regard. But hey, that's the past. Right now, on the 4th of December this year, Cabinet will take final decisions on broadband, on digital migration, and on releasing for public discussion a green paper on a national ICT integrated policy. And all investors, domestic and foreign, are most welcome to participate. It will be gazetted in the South African Gazette on the 6th of December or at the very latest on the 13th. The green paper will. And we are allowing for the next 4 to 5 months for the fullest discussion. And we welcome those who want to participate, not least from the international community.